Welcome to World Transits Today, exploring the planetary archetypes with their changing relationships, blending consciousness research with astrology. I'm Art Granoff. Today, April 22 on World Transits, we explore Sun conjunct Uranus, Sun square Pluto, Mercury conjunct Uranus, Venus conjunct Jupiter, Venus conjunct Neptune, celebrating Earth Day with Gaylord Nelson, Denis Hayes, and Rachel Carson, all with similar transits. Sun conjunct Uranus, world transit starts today for a month. The taste of possibility arriving, abruptly or out of the blue, with fresh air identifying a new direction, opening me up, greeting fresh possibilities as they arrive. The sun nourishes with warmth, providing life-sustaining power. The sun stands for me, who I am, my identity, my aspirations, style, and status. Also, my value to the pack. Sun is also what people think of me, which may or may not match my view. Uranus refers to innovation, speculation, with the hot knife slicing through outmoded ideas, yesterday's news and worn-out patterns. From the bouquet of fresh roses, Uranus oozing with personal gravitas, fresh direction awaits as the new day appears. Though watch for just dropping what's current, leaving commitments blowing in the wind. How about them old pants? Are they a little too tight or too loose? How about my ideas? Am I forecasting too low? Have my dreams expired or now just numbly routine? Hello, Uranus. Familiar with Prometheus, the mythological god who liberates fire, also known as knowledge, and offers to humankind? He went over the line and was forced to suffer. How does that relate to us? With Uranus the Awakener, have you noticed that each epiphany follows with pain and suffering? Just like old Prometheus. Watch the patterns. Sun conjunct Uranus through mid-May. The spring 2022 wake up, dialing my number. What's delicious, upcoming, and calling me? The only question is, will I be calling back? Also this week, it's Sun, Uranus, Pluto, identifying with big change. What could be better? Sun, Pluto, identifying with depth within, opening to an inner calling, finding a way to express myself that's exciting, original, with a personal problem overcome through a system that's universal, attractive, and resonates well with others. Sun, Uranus, Pluto, like the 1960s, an exciting week. Earth Day is an annual event, April 22, demonstrating support for environmental protection. First held in April 1970, now including a wide range of events coordinated globally by EarthDay.org, formerly Earth Day Network, including 1 billion people in more than 193 countries. I didn't know there were 193 countries. The official theme for 2022 is Invest in Our Planet. The first Earth Day protests brought 20 million Americans, 10% of the population at the time, into the streets. And here's the chart for Earth Day number one, April 22, 1970. With Venus opposite Neptune, Mercury opposite Uranus, and Uranus conjunct Pluto. Recognizing the power of this growing movement, Richard Nixon and Congress responded by making the EPA the Environmental Protection Agency, including the Clean Air Act, Clean Water Act, and Endangered Species Act. Nixon! All right. Please welcome Gaylord Nelson, an American politician and environmentalist who served 4 years as the Democratic governor of Wisconsin and 18 years as U.S. Senator. Nelson founded Earth Day, which began as a teach-in about environmental issues in April 1970. Nelson was praised by Vince Lombardi, the general manager and former coach of the Green Bay Packers, as the nation's number one conservationist. Nelson convinced President Kennedy to take a national speaking tour to discuss conservation issues. With President Johnson, he advanced civil rights legislation and waged the war on poverty. Nelson saw these battles as part and parcel of his environmental agenda, believing, and here's his quote, "Environment is all of America and its problems. It is rats in the ghetto. It is a hungry child in a land of affluence. It is housing not worthy of the name. Neighborhoods not fit to inhabit." And here's his chart. And what a chart it is. Nelson has Sun trine Uranus, with Sun conjunct Uranus in the sky. He's got Mercury trine Uranus, with Mercury conjunct Uranus in the sky. The Sun is identity. Mercury's the mind. I think. Add Uranus, the awakener. I think about new stuff. Jupiter square Neptune. Jupiter conjunct Neptune in the sky. Jupiter is elevated, growing. Neptune's imagination, flowing. Jupiter Neptune, the elevated view with imagination flowing. Venus conjunct Neptune. Venus is beauty, possibly a fever of human love. Neptune as the numinous, the sacred, also known as divine love. Venus, Neptune, the human heart melted into the transcendent, the results of meditation. Tenderness with tingles, singing a bhajan, a sacred Hindu song, or in Nelson's case, he created Earth Day. Bhakti, originally referring to devotion and love for a personal god or guru. Bhakti is not a ritualistic devotion to a god or religion, but participation in a path that includes behavior, ethics, mores, and spirituality. He's full of bhakti for the earth, wanting to protect her from harm. Mars opposite Uranus. Mars demonstrates, forces, achieves. Uranus opens, rebels, and releases. Mars Uranus, his quest, his plan, his action, new direction, forcing an opening, creating a conversation about slowing down industry, cleaning up pollution on the planet. And also Moon conjunct Neptune. His emotions are paired with the transcendent, his boundless giving. Please welcome Denis Allen Hayes, born 1944, is an American advocate for the environment, who rose to prominence in 1970 as the coordinator of Earth Day. He was a student at Harvard before being hired by Gaylord Nelson to organize the first Earth Day, participated in by 20 million Americans. Following the success of the first Earth Day, Hayes founded Earth Day Network and served as international chairman for Earth Day's anniversary. Internationally, he's recognized for expanding the Earth Day network to more than 180 nations. Currently, Earth Day is the world's most widely observed secular holiday. There's a couple of pictures of him. And here's his chart. Sun square Uranus, Mercury square Uranus. He's got Mars square Uranus. Mars is force or direct action for freedom. He's got the Moon, Mars, Neptune, Saturn, T-square. Moon square Mars, demonstrating gentle feelings with strength or too self-conscious to act. Moon opposite Saturn, tenderizing battle-worn Saturn or immediate hair-trigger discomforts. Moon square Neptune, he's a gentle practitioner of altruism, moon tender with Neptune, imagination, depth in fantasy, or someone with a helping others habit, keeps on giving regardless of the situation, or if that help is wanted or not. Venus conjunct Mars, Venus tender, Mars is tough, the perfect complement. Beauty meets the warrior and falls in love. And Venus conjunct Neptune, driven not only by love, but an internal dedication, placing the heart into the finest fantasy, receiving tasty fruits from the wonderful garden. Or, of course, the tender heart lost in a deep delusion. Let's welcome Rachel Carson. Hey, Rachel Louise Carson, 1907 to 1964, was an American marine biologist, writer, and conservationist whose influential book, Silent Spring, and other writings are credited with advancing the global environmental movement. Carson began her career as a biologist in the U.S. Bureau of Fisheries and became a full-time writer in the 50s. Her widely praised 1951 bestseller, The Sea Around Us, won her a U.S. National Book Award, recognition as a gifted writer, and financial security. After outscoring all other applicants on the civil service exam, in 1936, Carson became the second woman hired by the U.S. Bureau of Fisheries. She was promoted to editor-in-chief of all publications for the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service. Outlining the dangers of chemical pesticides, her book, Silent Spring, led to a nationwide ban on DDT and other pesticides and sparked the movement that ultimately led to the creation of the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency. After getting a letter from a friend about the loss of bird life after pesticide spraying, she wrote Silent Spring. The book primarily focuses on pesticides' effects on ecosystems, but has chapters that detail their impact on humans. She also accused the chemical industry of spreading misinformation and public officials of accepting industry claims uncritically. Roughly 15 million viewers tuned in on April 3rd, 1963, when The Silent Spring of Rachel Carson previewed on TV. Combined also with President John Kennedy's Science Advisory Committee report, which validated Carson's research, made pesticides a major public issue. Carson died from breast cancer in 1964. Silent Spring in 2006 was named one of the 25 greatest science books of all time by the editors of Discover magazine. And here's her chart. Full moon with Mercury. The sun with Mercury is the brilliant mind illuminated by the sun. Moon with Mercury, her passion for writing from her depths. Venus sextile Jupiter. Her big heart is activated. And Venus sextile Neptune, she's inspired. Mercury conjunct Pluto, getting to the bottom of things, bringing them to the surface. She writes about the earth, the sea, animals and humans being damaged by industry, dominating, polluting the environment, causing death and destruction, and of course, profits. She writes books about the hidden dangers of pesticides. She's vilified by industry. The FBI said since she's pretty and not married, she must be a communist. And Jupiter conjunct Neptune, big imagination, a large fantasy, guided by angels. Thanks for joining me on World Transits today, everybody. Talking about Earth Day, hey! World Transits is available at my site, Reference Astrology. Hear the audio version at Apple Podcasts. Contact me directly at Reference Astrology for a birth chart and transit reading, where we explore the planetary archetypes, place them on your chart, revealing your personal transits to see what's happening for you.